As we express our gratitude, we must never forget that the highest appreciation is not to utter words, but to live by them. Victory has 1,000 fathers, but defeat is an orphan. Change is the law of life, and those who look only to the past or present are certain to miss the future. There are risks and costs to action, but they are far less than the long-range risks of comfortable inaction. Conformity is the jailer of freedom and the enemy of growth. A nation that is afraid to let its people judge the truth and falsehood in an open market is a nation that is afraid of its people. Those who make peaceful revolution impossible will make violent revolution inevitable. Our problems are man-made, therefore they may be solved by man. And man can be as big as he wants. No problem of human destiny is beyond human beings. Physical fitness is not only one of the most important keys to a healthy body, it is the basis of dynamic and creative intellectual activity. Mankind must put an end to war before war puts an end to mankind. Leadership and learning are indispensable to each other. Our most basic common link is that we all inhabit this planet. We all breathe the same air. We all cherish our children's future. And we are all mortal. Too often we enjoy the comfort of opinion without the discomfort of thought. When power leads man toward arrogance, poetry reminds him of his limitations. When power narrows the area of man's concern, poetry reminds him of the richness and diversity of existence. When power corrupts, poetry cleanses. A man may die, nations may rise and fall, but an idea lives on. The greater our knowledge increases, the more our ignorance unfolds. For time and the world do not stand still. Change is the law of life, and those who look only to the past or the present are certain to miss the future. When written in Chinese, the word crisis is composed of two characters. One represents danger and the other represents opportunity. Peace is a daily, a weekly, a monthly process, gradually changing opinions, slowly eroding old barriers, quietly building new structures. Tolerance implies no lack of commitment to one's own beliefs. Rather, it condemns the oppression or persecution of others. Domestic policy can only defeat us. Foreign policy can kill us. Our growing softness, our increasing lack of physical fitness, is a menace to our security. Communism has never come to power in a country that was not disrupted by war or corruption, or both. Man is still the most extraordinary computer of all. Mothers all want their sons to grow up to be president, but they don't want them to become politicians in the process. The problems of the world cannot possibly be solved by skeptics or cynics whose horizons are limited by the obvious realities. We need men who can dream of things that never were. We stand today on the edge of a new frontier, the frontier of the 1960s, a frontier of unknown opportunities and perils, a frontier of unfulfilled hopes and threats. We are not afraid to entrust the American people with unpleasant facts, foreign ideas, alien philosophies, and competitive values. For a nation that is afraid to let its people judge the truth and falsehood in an open market is a nation that is afraid of its people. If anyone is crazy enough to want to kill a president of the United States, he can do it. All he must be prepared to do is give his life for the president's. My fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. Things do not happen. Things are made to happen. Let us not seek the Republican answer or the Democratic answer, but the right answer. Let us not seek to fix the blame for the past. Let us accept our own responsibility for the future. Let every nation know, whether it wishes us well or ill, that we shall pay any price, bear any burden, meet any hardship, support any friend, oppose any foe to assure the survival and the success of liberty. The ignorance of one voter in a democracy impairs the security of all. Efforts and courage are not enough without purpose and direction. Forgive your enemies, but never forget their names. We are tied to the ocean, and when we go back to the sea, whether it is to sail or to watch, we are going back from whence we came. The cost of freedom is always high, but Americans have always paid it. And one path we shall never choose, and that is the path of surrender, or submission. Let us never negotiate out of fear, but let us never fear to negotiate. The time to repair the roof is when the sun is shining. Those who dare to fail miserably can achieve greatly. Geography has made us neighbors. History has made us friends. Economics has made us partners, and necessity has made us allies. Those whom God has so joined together, let no man put asunder. The goal of education is the advancement of knowledge and the dissemination of truth. A child miseducated is a child lost. The great enemy of the truth is very often not the lie, deliberate, contrived and dishonest, but the myth, persistent, persuasive and unrealistic. For in the final analysis, our most basic common link is that we all inhabit this small planet. We all breathe the same air. We all cherish our children's futures. And we are all mortal. I think this is the most extraordinary collection of talent, of human knowledge, that has ever been gathered at the White House, with the possible exception of when Thomas Jefferson dined alone. Washington is a city of southern efficiency and northern charm. It is an unfortunate fact that we can secure peace only by preparing for war. The best road to progress is freedom's road. We are not here to curse the darkness, but to light the candle that can guide us through that darkness to a safe and sane future. The world is very different now, for man holds in his mortal hands the power to abolish all forms of human poverty, and all forms of human life. If we cannot now end our differences, at least we can help make the world safe for diversity. In the long history of the world, only a few generations have been granted the role of defending freedom in its hour of maximum danger. I do not shrink from this responsibility, I welcome it. A man does what he must, in spite of personal consequences, in spite of obstacles and dangers and pressures, and that is the basis of all human morality. If a free society cannot help the many who are poor, it cannot save the few who are rich.